stands for conscriptive youth. There's only this crime that can be done, I guess. But I think basically there are three or four issues. The first got to do with the synergy that I can think of. Then Adam spoke about the gender violence and the human rights. And then about support for what we did there. And then the investigative journalism of the investigative bureau. Okay, let me start from the software, which is also my passion, which is gender. And I'm sure some of you are already aware of the actions I've taken in order to really upscale the capacity of our gender. If you are not, what I've done on my assumption of office here is to relocate our gender unit from the command headquarters, former IRT. And as at this moment, we are working with the office of the first lady of the state and some NGOs to remodel it and modernize the facilities. So by the time we are done with that facility, we will have the western facilities for survivors, for even some containers. Because we were told in developing this concept, we work with about 40 of them. And developing jobs. It drew our attention to the fact that some containers, some survivors, victims of domestic violence, they report they might be scared going back to that same day because of fear of possible anger or assault by their husband. So we are now fashioning that we are facing this problem. So, in any 1 or 2 days that we try to then we have a children play area, we have a restaurant, we have kitchen, we have a call center, we have we don't want to call this, we are calling it a safe hospital for you that will be held in there. There will be case management offices, there will be physio, social support units, there will be legal units. So it's going to be, well, if not global standard, at least national standard. And so we would not, some NGOs are keen to it. If you are free to go there, now the modeling has started. And I do hope I'll be able to push it more. I see the other state. If I can't, at least the dream is already sent to the United. So we are doing that. So I don't think we should have anything to worry about. The only thing we are saying is that if that capacity is still, the natural consequence will be that there will be more confidence. Because the confidence in the police to handle such things will also be enhanced. So people will have more confidence to help me out. And it's a major problem. In fact, to me, gender-based violence, sexual abuse and family related violence is one of the, if not the highest crime.
Yes.
Because unfortunately, it was fully reported because of the social cultural factors.
Yes.
So they are trying to address that. We'll be glad if crime in the heart of it, that we have a policy to bring it together for the people that can increase the
people.
So, human rights abuses, yes, I am concerned. Nothing can create a gap between the police and the citizens and issues relating to abuse of judicial powers. Try, within my leadership capacity, that is the standard of bit by bit, you can get there. But the actual action that we are to do, which is also linked to the question, is the establishment of a complete responsibility.